Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Today we're going to solve your workbook page number 29 and 30. So please, everyone, open your workbook page number 29 that I'm going to write here. So that is your workbook page number 29. So let's start one by one all about it. So the first question that mentioned here, choose the correct letters or the word here that give you the best answer. So question number one that is mentioned here, the flexible wrapping that surrounded all cells is called the. So the options are here, number A, cytoplasm, number B, cell wall, number C, cell membrane, and D is vacuole. So the best option is here. If you know the answer, you can send me in the chat. So the correct one is number C, okay? After that, from your workbook, question number two, which of these structures is found in a plant cell, but not in an animal cell? The structure here or organelles, you can say that these are mentioned here from which are present in plant, but not in animal. So let's see one by one. Number A is central vacuole, number two, B, mitochondria, C, nucleus, and D, organelles. So the best option is here, central vacuole, because animal cell don't have a central vacuole. They have in the center is a nucleus, but in plant cell, you can find a big vacuole in the center. After that, we move to number three question. Which of the following is the correct order from simplest to most complex? Mean to say we move from simple to the complex one. Okay, understand? So let's see. Simple mean that started from the beginning. So number A is cells, tissues, organs, organism, organ system. B, cells, tissues, organs, organ system, organism. That's the B one. So the B is the correct one. Okay. So we know that it started from cells and it will finish to the organism. But if you see here in the others, we didn't find any specific grade or order. Okay. So this B is the correct one. After that, we move to number four. Which phylum has the most species? So you know very well, we learned about all the phylum. So the number D, Arthropoda, has the more or the most species in it. So the option for number four question is option number D. Then we move to number five. In which kingdom all of the members obtain energy by breaking down dead organisms? So plants, no, we know that plants get energy by photosynthesis, then the animals by digestion, and C, yeah, these are the fungi or the fungi. They get energy by dead organisms, or the protists, or also can perform photosynthesis. Now, after that, we move to number six. Which life process do viruses carry out? So the viruses can carry out only one process. So it's number six is the correct option is A, that is reproduction. They can't move, they can't grow, they can't use energy. So they only can perform only one function that we name as reproduction. After that, the question number seven on page number 29 from your science workbook, which structure found in vascular plants allow for the transport of water? So the water and minerals move in a plant. You know very well that structure or these tissues are xylem tissues. Okay. So I hope everyone complete this page number 29. After solving this, and if someone is still missing, he can take the screenshot, and even you miss this or you miss any detailed answer, you can go to my YouTube channel and you can easily understand about this. Now, my dear student, I'm going to move on page number 30. So after solving this, we move on page number 30. So let's see the correct options here on page number 30. So now that is in front of you, page number 30, the question number 8. Yes, my dear, okay, no problem. The student, they're sending the answers, maximum correct one. But if you have any ambiguity or you have any doubt, you can see here and tell your answers again. A fire tree is an example of A and dash. A fire tree is an example of, yes, well done. Very nice, excellent. The correct option is here, number D, gymnosperms. A carrot root is an example of A or N. A carrot root, you know very well about that. Well done, good, very nice, my dear. That is an example of taproot. Well done, the correct option is here, number A. Okay, now we move to number 10. Which of the following moves sugar that are made in the plant's leaves? So you know very well, water and minerals move in a plant with the help of xylem. So that is not the correct one. And the cambium is only a spreader. You can say that that separates both these two. Bark is also the outer one. So the correct option is number B. Well done. Very nice. Excellent, my dear students. Okay. After that, we move to question number 11. Which group includes the simplest animals? So the answer here on number 11 is sponges. Sponges have the simplest animals in them. So number 12, animals have radial symmetry. Radial means like a round, okay? Just like a circle, round, radial, okay? Like a cycle, like this. This is page number 30. Okay, no problem. After solving page number 29, we on page number 30. So the correct answer of number 12 is, very good. Okay, that's great. That is number D, cnidarians. Well done, very nice, my dear. So we move on page number, question number 13. Which vertebrates have gills when they hatch and lungs when they are adults? Very interesting question. So the vertebrates, you know that they have a backbone. First, they have gill when they hatch, and after that, they start to breathe with the lungs when they become adult. So the question number 13, these are amphibians. Well done. Very nice. Very good. Excellent, my dear. Okay. Now, question number 14, which organ filters waste from the blood? So it is very easy to know. For you, there is an organ in our body that perform a function to just filter, okay, the waste products or the waste things that produce in our body. That, yes, very good, excellent, well done, my dear. So the question number 14, these are kidneys. So the last question here on your workbook page number 30. So the 15th question is that where does blood travel next after returning from the body cell to the lungs? Well done. Very nice. So these are all your possible and correct options on page number 30. So till here, if you have any question, please raise your hand. Otherwise, type no in the chat. Then we move on. Okay, no problem, no problem. Thank you very much. Okay, that's great. Now please take the screenshot. I'm going to share. Yeah. Textbook. Now we move to the textbook after that. Don't worry, my dear, don't worry. Okay, thank you very much. That's okay. Now, I'm going to share the textbook from chapter number 2, lesson number 1. Yes, page number 90. That is your today's work that we're going to start. So that this lesson is about reproduction. Yes, on page number 90. Page number 990. Yes, that is lesson 1 about the reproduction. So let's start this lesson. Okay, my dear. So let's start this from page number 90. So today's topic about the sexual and asexual reproduction. So let's start this. What is reproduction? Or you can say that the meaning of reproduction. So let's see, how do living things come from? That is a very interesting question. Or where do living things comes from? Living things comes from other living things. We know very well, like a puppy or a kitten, that is comes from their parents, from their dog or from cat. And in the same way, a plant, a baby plant, will come from a seed. A seed is also a part of a plant or a part of a tree. The survival of a species depends on its ability to produce new members. So if a species or a plant can grow up, they can produce new ones. Every organism comes from a parent. Number one, organisms through the process of reproduction. So what is that mean? Re mean again. Production mean to produce. So reproduction, they can reproduce. This is a process. So what is reproduction? Involves the transfer of genetic material. So what is the meaning of genetic material? Properties, characteristics that present in your parents, that comes from your parents to you, from parents to offspring. Offspring mean here the new upcoming babies or newborn babies or the children. Okay, my dear, the genetic material contains information that controls how the new individual will look and function. There are two types of reproduction. So let's see these two types. Number one is here sexual. That is number one type of reproduction. And the second type of reproduction is asexual. So these two are the types of reproductions. So let's see both of these types one by one. But before to dive into these two types, I'm going to share with you a screen. So please, everyone, open this link, and also you can see this screen that I'm going to share with you now. So that is the screen. You can easily see from here. So here also a question is mentioned like this form. Differentiate between sexual and asexual reproduction. Yes, this is a question. I just make a question for you to try to make it more easy. Now the students, they just joined the meeting. Please open the link. No problem. I will take your question. Just give me only 2 minutes. First, let me to explain. Then I will let you to ask the question. So please, everyone in the meeting, they just joined the meeting. You open this link or the screen where I am now. So here you can find number first about the sexual reproduction. What it mean? So sexual reproduction, that mentioned here, sexual reproduction is the production of new organism from two parents in which you involve two parents, okay? Like here, one is female, second is male. So you have two parents, okay? Now male father and female mother. When their cells, the cells, we can say that the sex cells we name as egg and sperms. These two cells combine. This combination, after that, a process going. There is another process we name as fertilization that inshallah we discuss tomorrow. And then we get a new individual or a baby individual. After the combination of these two cells, we get a new baby or an individual. This is a sexual reproduction. Now, after understanding this, I am going to take you back on your textbook, page number 90. Here you can see that a sexual reproduction is the production of a new organism from two parents, a sperm cell. One is a sperm cell from a male and an egg cell from a female joined into a single unit. This process called fertilization. Okay, my dear, what we call this? This process is named as fertilization. The fertilized egg cells contain genetic material. Genetic material, what it means? For example, if your eyes color same like maybe your father or like your mother, or maybe you have same hair like your parents, maybe one of them like your father or like your mother, from both parents, it will come from both of them. The fertilized egg then goes on to develop into a new individual, okay? The new individual will receive some characteristics or traits. What is mean? Some properties. Maybe your voice is like your father. Maybe your hairs like your mother. Maybe your color, you're like father. From each parent, a trait is any characteristic, any property of a living thing. For example, a plant may be tall and have pink flowers. Height and flower color are traits that may be passed to offspring from parents. So till here, my dear students, if you have any question, you can raise your hand. Otherwise, type no in the chat. Everyone quickly. Hurry up, my dear. Yes, well done. Very nice. Okay, the students now, they raise their hand. I will let them. First, I'm going to give chance to Ali Khalid. Yes, my dear Ali. Quickly.
Teacher, yesterday I bring the workbook.
Okay.
And I don't write in it anything. Only.
No problem, Mr. Ali. I upload all the recorded videos on the YouTube, so you can go there and complete them. Okay. Yes, Muhammad Waleed. Yes, Mr. Waleed.
Teacher.
Yes.
What?
Why you raise your hand? No question?
Okay,
no problem. Yes, Ahmed, Mr. Ahmed.
Yes. The workbook I put to you, the answer of page 29 and 30, it was correct. I bought all.
Okay, well done. Very nice. Excellent. No problem. Yes, Mr. Talal Said. Yes, my dear. Mr. Talal.
Teacher, I'm not finished number 14 and 15.
Okay, no problem. I will share again. Okay, after that, Abdullah Umar. Yes, my dear.
Can I read?
I will give you a chance. Just a minute. Okay. Yes, Mr. Yazan. Don't worry, I will give you. Yazan, hurry up.
I don't understand.
Okay, I will explain again. Stay with me. Okay, Umar Waleed. Yes, my dear.
Teacher, only you have that.
No, after that, we're going to the next part. Till here, any question?
No.
Okay, that's great. Okay, now, till here, my dear student, what we understand, we learn about a process, or you can say that, in which we get new individual by a sexual reproduction, okay? Now, after this, I'm going to take you on the next page. That is page number 91, okay? So please, everyone, open your textbook, page number 91. From here, we're going to discuss about the second part of this lesson. That is your chapter number 2 and lesson number 1, where you can understand after sexual reproduction, then we have another type of reproduction, that is asexual, okay? What happened during asexual reproduction? So you need to open your textbook page 91. When you open this page, you can see here, number one, the definition that is mentioned here. Yes, please. Okay, no problem, my dear. So let's start to discuss this process. This is page number 91, my dear. Asexual reproduction, what is this? And what happening during this production? So here, asexual reproduction is the production of new organisms, okay? We also get here new organisms like sexual reproduction, but from a single parent. But here we have a single parent. In sexual reproduction, we have two parents, but here we have single parents. It produces a new offspring that has the same genetic information. It has the same genetic information as the parent. No male and female sex cells combine. You know very well, during sexual, we have mother and father, mean to say male and female and male, okay? We both have their cells. For example, from female, we get egg. And from male, we get sperms. Okay? When they combine this for female and this for male, okay? So they combine together. And then we get a new organism, or you can say that offspring or baby, like this, okay? But during asexual reproduction, the only one parent will use, and sex cell combination during asexual reproduction is not happening, okay? Since there is only one parent, look, there is only one parent in asexual reproduction, genetic information is not mixed. So there is no mixing of traits or the genetic information. The offspring are identical to the original. Identical mean same. Identical mean same like their parent. Maybe same like mother or same like father. So to the original parents, whatever their original parent. Now I'm going to take you back on the screen here. You can easily understand, and you can find the difference between sexual and asexual. So the first thing you can see here, this is the sexual reproduction. Male, female, their cells combine, egg and sperm, and get a new baby. But during asexual reproduction, you can easily see, first from the definition, what mentioned here, number one, sexual reproduction is the production of new organism from a single parent. Look, this is a single parent here, okay? This is a single parent. And you get same like this parent, a new individual, same like his father or his parent. So in this way, this is going to move and reproduce new offspring, but this process we name as asexual reproduction. Here at the bottom of this page, you can easily see the difference and the examples of different organisms. They have sexual and asexual. So here, this is asexual examples like unicellular organisms, hydras, and sweet potatoes. They reproduce not only animals, the plants also can reproduce with this process. And here, the sexual reproduction, like in human, cats, dogs, and many other plants, they can give new ones with the help of this reproduction. So till here, my dear students, if you have any question, please raise your hand, otherwise type no. Everyone, quickly. Very nice. Excellent, my dear. Well done. So after that, we again come back to your textbook. So please open your textbook page number 91. 91. Everyone, please. Yes. Sure. Sure, my dear. No problem. No problem. Inshallah, we will complete. Okay. So you can find organisms that reproduce asexually in all six kingdoms, not only in one kingdom. In all the six kingdoms, you can find the organisms, all members of the bacteria kingdom, and most unicellular. You know very well about the uni mean one, single cells organisms. Protists produce asexually. Most fungi or fungi and many plants can reproduce asexually. Okay, so here many plants, they also can reproduce during a part of their life and sexually during another. So they have two life cycles, in which one life cycle is going with the help of asexually and second with sexually. Animals such as jellyfish, here are the examples of animals, okay? Jellyfish, worms, and some echinoderms can form new offspring asexually. Some kinds of lizards, frogs, fish, and insects can also reproduce asexually. So till here, my dear students, if you have any question, please raise your hand, otherwise type no in the chat. Well done. Very nice. Excellent idea. That's great. Thank you very much.